Lindsay Kelleher. I'm here today at the Newburyport Farmers Market reporting for Port Media, your local public access channel. The Farmers Market takes place every Sunday in the summer and fall from 9 a.m. to 1 p.m. rain or shine. We're here today with
Liz Conrad, Riversley Farm.
Can you tell us a little bit about the story behind your product here and what you're selling?
Well, my husband and I have been farming in Epping, New Hampshire for about 20 years. We raise sheep and goats for meat and fiber and hides, and we bring our own yarn and our naturally raised lamb and goat meat and meals to the market every week, and it's great to be here.
Yeah. That's great. Have you guys been here before? I believe this started up last summer.
Yeah, actually, we joined last September. We did the winter session, and then we came back for this summer as well. And it's really growing, and it's an exciting thing to be part of.
That's very cool. So what do you have for sale here?
We have our naturally raised lamb and goat meat. We have meals that a chef prepares for us, so you can come here and take home your dinner. We also have beautiful hand-dyed and hand-spun yarns. Lisa, my friend, is our fiber artist. She makes magnificent things, vases and all kinds of artwork. And we have lamb skins, goat skins, nesting balls for the birds to take the wool and line their nests. We have all kinds of things. If you can make it with wool and lambs and goats, we do.
Oh, that's very cool. All right, thank you so much. Is there anything else you want to say?
Just thank you to the community. We feel very welcomed here, and we appreciate the community support.
Okay, thank you very much. Hi, it's Mackenzie. I'm here with Eastman's Fish at the Newburyport Farmers Market. Could you tell us a little bit about your product?
What we do is we bring local fish into these kind of communities. We catch it out of Seabrook, New Hampshire, so it's all really fresh. We cut it the day before, so it's all going to be really fresh, really nice. And we just want to spread local fish because it's really hard to find around here.
Hi, this is Mackenzie. I'm here with
Brad
from
Not Again.
And what are you selling here?
I make cutting boards. The primary woods that I use are cherry, black walnut, and maple.
Great. Is this your first time at the farmer's market? I believe it started up last summer.
This is my first year at this farmer's market, and I'm a guest vendor, so I'm not here every week. A lot of the people are here every week, but I'm a local artisan from New Hampshire, but I've been invited to come down and participate.
Yeah, that's great. I live actually across the street from here, and I see a lot of action going on here on Sundays. Do you think it's been good for the community, pretty successful?
Oh, absolutely. Absolutely. And from what I'm hearing from the other vendors, this year is a lot better than last year as well. So it looks like it's picking up.
Oh, that's really great. So you sell some cutting boards. It looks like you have some doorstops.
The primary thing that I make are cutting boards. However, with leftover material from the cutting boards, I make other projects as well. The name Not Again basically comes from the fact that I try to use as much recycled wood as I can.
That's great. Is there anything else you want to say about your product, like where you get your materials from, anything like that?
I buy from a local store up in Brentwood, New Hampshire. And they're a certified green company, so again, we're trying to, work with the environment and do as much as we can.
Definitely, that's great. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Hi, we're here at the farmers market today with
My name is Jonathan Blakesley from White Heron Tea in Rollinsford, New Hampshire.
That's great. How long have you been participating in this farmer's market or farmer's markets in general?
This is our second year at the Newburyport Farmer's Market. This is our fourth year doing farmer's markets in general.
That's great. So where do the materials for your products come from? Where do you get your materials?
We're an organic certified tea processor handler, and some ingredients do come from here. Teas do not grow in our area, as we know. One of the ways that we got into farmers markets initially is that we are an organic certified tea processor handler. So we have tea that comes from India, Nepal, China, etc. But Everything that we do is hand-blended, hand-packaged, hand-labeled. And we do use like organic Massachusetts cranberries, American-grown organic spearmint, peppermint, various other ingredients. And we also have a lot of food items that we offer at our weekend farmers markets. And we use as many local ingredients as possible. Like in the case of falafel wrap that we have there, instead of using garbanzo beans, we use dried main beans and things like that.
Thank you very much. That's great. Here at the Newburyport Farmers Market, they have everything from sheep's wool to pottery to food to vegetables to baked goods. It's a really exciting community event, and we hope that you'll stop by. It's on every Sunday morning in the summer and fall from 9 a.m. till 1 p.m., rain or shine, and it's definitely a really good community event, so please stop by. Thank you.
Starting in late May, there will be asparagus available. Starting in June, there will be lettuce, radishes, beets, and cabbage available. Starting in mid-June, there will be strawberries, turnips, spinach, and winter squash available. Starting in July, there will be sweet corn, scallions, beans, carrots, peas, raspberries, and escarole available. In mid-July, there will be blueberries, tomatoes, cucumbers, zucchini, onion, cauliflower, and Chinese cabbage available. Starting in August, there will be grapes, cantaloupes, peppers, peaches, eggplant, and apples available. Starting in mid-August, there will be parsnips, celery, and potatoes available. And starting in September, there will be pumpkins and cranberries available.